Are you feeling like you can't catch your breath and you're overwhelmed by family expectations? Many new moms think they just have to accept the endless amounts of advice and the revolving door visits. But what if I told you there's a better way? In today's video, I'll reveal the 9 essential postpartum boundaries that will protect your peace and put your family first. Imagine having a clear plan that keeps your baby safe, ensures you get the rest you need, and maintains harmony with your loved ones. To kick things off, what is your biggest worry about handling family and in-laws after your baby arrives? Drop it in the comments below. Okay, postpartum boundary number 1, no unannounced visits.
I know, shocker, right?
When you bring your baby home, you need rest. Your home is not a revolving door of visitors. Before the baby arrives, you need to sit your family down and explain that visits need to be scheduled. Make sure it's so clear that you're not shutting people out, you're not keeping them away from their grandbaby, but that it's necessary for you guys to rest, bond, and recuperate.
I mean, thinking back to my first moments out of the hospital after I gave labor, I mean, I was getting tucked by the truckload. I couldn't imagine being like up for unannounced guests. Like, that just would not have worked for me. So yes, scheduled visitors, 100%.
Here's a possible script. We are so excited for you to meet the baby. To make sure we get the rest we need, we're asking that all visits be scheduled ahead of time, and we'll let you know when we're up for visitors. Studies show that structured visiting hours reduce stress levels by up to 30%, which stress, that impacts your recovery, sleep, the little bit you get, and milk production. So 30%, that's pretty significant. How you hold this boundary is if someone shows up unannounced, you politely but firmly let them know that you're not available for visitors right now and remind them to please schedule next time. For example, I would say something like, oh shoot, we're not up for visitors right now. I wish you would have called. Can you please remember to call before next time so we can set up a visit? But I'm curious, how do you feel about setting specific visiting hours? Have you tried it? How did it go? Postpartum boundary number 2, health and safety first. Newborns have delicate immune systems, so setting boundaries around health is critical. So make it clear that anyone feeling unwell should reschedule their visit. I remember a friend who had her parents come over. Now her dad had just a tiny little sniffle. Well, that little sniffle turned into a week-long hospital stay for her baby. After that, she always insists that everyone is healthy before they come into her house. Here's a possible script. We can't wait for you to meet the baby. Just a reminder, if anyone feels under the weather, please reschedule your visit for everyone's safety. According to the CDC, limiting exposure to sick individuals can reduce newborn illnesses by 50%. How you hold the line for this boundary? If a visitor arrives and you suspect, like, Bob, I think you're sick, it's important to speak up. I would say, I'm concerned about my baby's health. Could we please reschedule this for another time when everyone's feeling well? Postpartum boundary number 3, prioritize self-care and recovery. I know it doesn't seem like the right time to be focusing on you, but it's important. The postpartum period is crucial for a mom's physical and mental recovery. So it's imperative to set boundaries that allow you to prioritize self-care without feeling guilty. Something you could say is, I need to prioritize my recovery right now, so I'm focusing on some time to rest and focus on my health. I appreciate your understanding and support during this time. According to a study by the American Psychological Association, prioritizing self-care during the postpartum period significantly reduces the risk of postpartum depression and anxiety by up to 50%. How you hold the line is if you feel pressured by a family member to entertain or take on more than you can handle, remind yourself and others that your health and well-being are your top priorities. And for example, if a family member wants to visit and you know, like, geez, I just can't do this today, you need to say, I'm focusing on resting right now, so let's plan for a visit when I'm feeling more up to it. Postpartum boundary number 4 is a biggie. But before we get into that, I should welcome any newbies to our channel.
My name is Jess. I am a boundary enthusiast obsessed with everything boundaries. And if you want to learn more about how boundaries can change your life, make sure you hit that subscribe button and stick around.
Okay, back to boundary number 4, respecting parental choices. Every family is different and your choices should be respected. This includes feeding methods, sleep routines, and parental philosophies. My best friend was constantly bombarded with unsolicited advice about breastfeeding until she finally had a heart-to-heart with her mother-in-law, and she was like, this is not going to be good for our relationship. We need to switch things up a little bit. Here's a passable script. We appreciate your experience and advice. We're doing what works best for us right now, and we would love your support in that. How you hold the line with this boundary. When unsolicited advice comes up, you can say, thank you so much for your suggestions. Like, you have so much experience. We're following this plan right now that works for us, and we would appreciate your support. I'm curious, have you experienced unsolicited advice about parenting? How did you handle it? Comment below. Postpartum boundary number 5, privacy during feedings. Feeding times should be a private, stress-free, like low-key time. Let your family know that you need some alone time during this like important bonding activity. So something you could say is, feeding time is really special for us, so we're just gonna need a little bit of privacy during these moments, but we'll be right back to join you. How you hold the line for this boundary, like if somebody lingers or if they're just not getting the hint, you could just gently remind them and say, this is our quiet time for feeding, so we'll rejoin you shortly. Postpartum boundary number 6, limiting social media exposure. In today's digital age, it's important to control what gets shared online. Make it super clear what photos and updates you want out there about your baby, and that nothing should be shared without your consent. So here's a script. We would like to keep our baby's presence online minimal, if at all. Please don't post any pictures without checking with us first. According to a survey by the Baby Center, 80% of parents are concerned with their children's privacy online. And how you hold the line. Let's say you see somebody post a picture without your permission. I would just contact them directly and request they take it down. I would say, we know you didn't mean any harm, but we're keeping our baby's online presence minimal or not at all, and could you please remove that photo? Postpartum boundary number 7, time to bond. In the initial weeks, focus on bonding with your baby. Limit visits to short duration and only to close family members. My friend's in-laws stayed for 3 weeks, and while they helped around the house, it was a lot. They ended up having a frank conversation and setting future visits like much shorter durations. Here's a possible script. We're still in our bonding period, so we're going to keep the visit shorter for now, but we can't wait to spend more time with you. And holding the line for this boundary can be tricky because they're already there, but if the visits are becoming too much or too lengthy, or you can feel tired, you can just say, I'm feeling a little tired or overwhelmed. I need some quiet time, so let's wrap this up for today and we'll plan another visit soon. Postpartum boundary number 8, household help over baby holding. When family members offer to help, it's much more beneficial if they assist with chores rather than holding your baby. This support is invaluable.
My mother-in-law, I've shared this before, came over for the first 3 weeks when I had a baby, and she would clean my house, make us food, and it was seriously a lifesaver. This showed me how helpful I can be to my kids when they eventually start to have kids.
Here's a possible script. We really appreciate your help. Right now, it would be amazing if you could help with the dishes, with meal prep, with laundry, while we focus on our baby. Here's a great statistic. Families who receive practical help, such as meal prep, house cleaning, yard work, report 40% lower stress levels. And again, lower stress is what you need right now. You are already running on fumes with lack of sleep, recovery, like your body is healing, and your hormones are all over the place. Stress is a big factor. Monitor it so closely. Any way you can lower your stress, do it. How you hold this boundary is when someone offers to hold the baby, just redirect their help. Could you please like help me with a load of dishes or laundry instead? That would be a huge help for us right now. Before I get to the final postpartum boundary, I need to ask you something.
Have you learned one thing today? If so, can you give me a thumbs up, like hit that like button? And if you've learned 2 things, consider subscribing to the channel. We would love to welcome you to the Mind Your Boundary community.
Okay. Postpartum boundary number 9, boundaries on gift giving and hand-me-downs. This can get overwhelming so quick. Set clear expectations for gifts and hand-me-downs. Like, while it's super sweet, you don't want to be swimming in stuff you're never going to use. Here's what I would say. We appreciate your generosity so much. To keep things manageable, we've made a list of what we really, really, really need. And how you hold line is, if you receive items that are not on your list, you can thank the giver and explain your needs. Thank you so much for this gift. We're trying to keep things minimal, so we might not be able to use everything. Could we store some of the items at your your place until we need them. The biggest thing I need you to hear today is setting these boundaries isn't about shutting out your loved ones. You are not being mean. You are not pushing them away from spending time with their newest little bundle. It's about creating a supportive environment for your new little family. Just remember, clear communication is key. Proactively talk with your family before the baby arrives and explain your needs and boundaries. This approach helps avoid misunderstandings and ensures everybody is on the same page. Also remember, it's okay to feel a little guilty about setting boundaries. That's normal. It's just all a part of ensuring the best possible start for your baby and your growing family. So what do you think? Did we miss anything? Let me know in the comments, like if we missed a boundary that you feel like, no, this should have definitely made the list. Put it in the comments. For more valuable boundary insights and tips, click on the next video somewhere around here. Until next time, friend, make sure you keep minding your boundaries.